For more than 11 years, relatives of people who disappeared during the separatist movement in Pakistan have gathered outside press club of Quetta, wanting to know who took their fathers, husbands and sons. Din Muhammad, a doctor who was kidnapped by unknown men in 2009. Since then, there is a regular sit-in protest in the provincial capital of Balochistan.
Relative suspect Muhammad, like many other missing ethnic Baloch, was kidnapped by Pakistani security forces during crackdown on separatists. Sometimes these few disappeared people actually return back after decades of waiting, while most of the time their mutilated dead bodies are found. As per reports submitted by Baloch representatives in the United Nations, 20,000 people have disappeared so far. So we would like to know what led to this situation in Balochistan and why their voices are still unheard.
Balochistan is the biggest province of Pakistan, sandwiched between Afghanistan and Iran. Geostrategically, geopolitically, and geoeconomically, it is most important province of Pakistan, well endowed with nature and very rich in natural resources. By area, it is 44% of Pakistan's total landmass, while only 5% of its population live there. Though Balochistan is very rich in natural resources, it is one of the poorest region in Pakistan.
In August 1947, while British were leaving India, they gave the option of absolute independence to all of India's princely state. While Pakistan was carved out of India, Balochistan too declared its independence.
On March 1948, however, armed forces of Pakistan were mobilized to launch an operation in Balochistan. Khan of Kalat, one of the major rulers of Balochistan, was captured, and Balochistan was forcefully annexed into Pakistan. The people of Balochistan were against this forceful annexation and launched a movement with objective to protect the interest, cultural identity of Baloch people. Pakistan Army, however, responded to these movements heavily by kidnapping, torturing and killing of the local people. It only forced Baloch people to pick up weapons and respond aggressively.
Since 1948, there have been 5 phases of insurgencies. The 5th and the current one is the deadliest of all, leaving thousands of people dead. But the conflict is not seeming to be over anytime soon. Pakistan's establishment too is literally doing everything to further deteriorate the situation. In a textbook in Pakistan for the subject sociology, Baloch are described as uncivilized, illiterate and savage. With fractured democracy and Pakistan's military's involvement in almost all of decision-making bodies only convinced Baloch leaders to fight for their absolute independence.
The recent clashes, however, are due to extreme exploitation of natural resources. For example, Sui gas field in Dera Bukti in Balochistan is extremely used by Pakistan government to supply gas to rest of the country. Baloch local people, however, are still living without any gas or electricity. Another major reason for recent increase in attacks is CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. In 2006, Pakistan handed over Gwadar to China for development. Over decades, there have been few development, but only to serve China and Pakistan's interests. Local Baloch people are watching as Chinese laborers, engineers are settling down in their land, exploiting their resources for China's benefit. While Balochistan and its people are getting nothing, which they describe as modern-day colonialism, exactly what British did to India.
But what is even more concerning here for Balochistan is their forceful demographic change. With the development of Gwadar, Pakistani Punjabis have started settling into that area, which local Baloch leaders fear they will be minorities into their own homeland, and it will tighten Pakistan's grip into their country. But whatever will be the development further, we will share it with you. Please subscribe to our channel. This is Shantanu for Samvad.